Welcome to another video. It's my pleasure to be here with you today. Today we're going to talk about a past life meditation that I experienced about a week ago now. And I'm going to share with you my story. Discuss with you what I experienced, what I felt, and where it's led me to in the present moment. So, I want to give you the lowdown of how to prepare for a meditation or ritual or recall like this. You want to make a sacred space for yourself and whoever else you may be participating with. If it's just yourself, then that's fine. If you choose to do it with a partner or with a friend, that's good too. Because what we did is we laid down two yoga mats. We had some drumming music on in the background, and we set our altar's intention to clear the space, have this space be sacred in order to bring about a safe place to do such a type of recall. So, you see, I've done a past life recall once before, but it was more like an astral travel meditation. And I remember that I got quite a lot out of it, but I don't think I was fully ready for the information, so it kind of stopped halfway through, and that was about a year and a half ago now. And over this last year or so, I've been getting inclinations towards wanting to check out past lives and find out if there's something in it for me, if there is part of me that could find such information useful. And this was given to me in the form of a couple girlfriends reaching out that I hadn't spoken to in a while, and they both told me about their past life regression, so to speak. A massive shout out to Cosmic Tangles, because she gave me a whole list of things that I could apply before doing the meditation, apply to the ritual, including using music, so using drumming in the background, cleansing the space, using our altar, our crystals, and setting them into a grid. Now I want to get into my experience with you. I'm going to be honest and say that I've debated sharing this with you. I already know the story myself, and I feel like I've been able to glean a lot of, a lot of good feeling has come from this experience. Deeper knowledge, deeper understanding of who I am has happened for me during this process. And the reason that I want to share it with you, whoever you are that is watching, is because if I can inspire you as I was inspired, then I'm just passing on that gift of trying something new and receiving something magnificent out of it. So, after having done my prayers, my words of gratitude, my affirmations, calling on my angels, calling on spirit guides, whomever came up in the moment for me to give thanks to and say my prayers to. I then went into some toning with my voice, and the toning is kind of just letting any sound come through. It could be could be any other sound similar. And so I went into a toning phase, and eventually I lied down. It starts, my experience starts with seeing a beautiful lion, and this lion has wings. He, she can fly, and she takes me out of where I am in my house, astral body style, of course, and takes me to my ancient home. And this ancient home, I think I've been, I've thought about it, I've been dreaming it up ever since I was a little girl, but there was a time in my life where it really came to life. And it was during a period of time when I was working for a store called Tiger, and I used to be at the front desk serving people at the tills, and I used to wish away shifts with me being in my imagination in this ancient home. I used to pretend that I was really in this ancient home as opposed to in the store working. This home was full of all the things that I could ever want. Every room has something different in it for the elements. So there's a warm room, there's a cold room, and it was such a joy to bring through my imagination and dreaming up this place. And this is where the winged lion took me to. And I descend some stairs. I know that I'm going deeper now into my being, and I begin to get a little bit nervous. And so when I feel these nerves come about, I'm greeted by my old cat, Ali, who I didn't have for very long, but she's always stayed with me. I didn't get to keep her, but for the short time that I had her, I'm so grateful, because she was the best cat in the world. She really was. She really is. And she was there in this house to greet me, and she really helped me to calm my nerves. I walk through this, what I would call a Milky Way portal, and as soon as I step inside, I'm greeted by Hathor, goddess of love. She has come to me once before in my past life, meditation, and she showed me ancient Egypt the last time. And I was able to glean a lot of information from that past life meditation, but it stopped because I think I wasn't ready for it until now. And so when I saw her, I knew that she was there to help me again. So seeing her there was of great comfort, and as I looked out, I saw an invisible pathway in front of me, and there was an infinite amount of doors on either side of me. So even more than what my picture that I made shows. And there's just doors infinitum, and I can't see the end of this path, actually. Only later do I see the sun emerge. And so I'm walking down this pathway, and I'm looking at these doors, all with different labels on them, and I'm nervous. I don't know which door to choose. I don't even know if I want to look. I'm in a space of, wow, this is feeling kind of real. At the same time, I'm kind of scared for some reason to do this. And so Hathor begins to do Reiki on me. She starts by the top of my head, going down into my neck and shoulders, arms, hands, chest, torso, stomach, hips, thighs, calves, feet, and a huge weight feels lifted from me. And then drums begin to play. And it's the drumming that I can hear from the music we're playing, but they play synchronistically. They play in a way that's perfect for that moment, because as soon as the Reiki is finished, I stand up and I begin to dance now. Dance down this pathway. And I realize that I'm being called by the sun, and I'm not meant to open any doors just yet. So I listen to the call of the sun, and I hear it. I hear her call, I hear his call, and again I become afraid. I think back to the last time that I was called to the sun, and the last time I was called to the sun, I became too afraid to go, and I didn't go to the sun during my astral experience. I don't even know if it was an astral. I think it may have been a vision I was having at the time, and I was asked. It may have even been a dream, you know, it was many years ago, I don't remember, but I was asked once before if I would go to the sun. And even though I wanted to, I was too afraid. But this time I was hearing the drumming music and I was dancing down this path that is my soul's path. And I could do nothing but go towards the sun. Hathor waits for me on the other side as I step into this portal, because I'm alone again. And for a moment there's blackness, there's stillness, and I'm a little bit unsure of myself. I'm a little bit hesitant to do or think or maybe even want to kind of open my eyes at this point. But all of a sudden I remember to call in my angels and I ask, let there be light. And there is light that comes. And what I see before me inside of the sun is a campfire. Would you believe it? Kind of weird, I know. And around this campfire there is six people. Six that are really eight, so I'm told in the moment. Two are on errands, so they will come to me in another time. And I'm dancing around this circle with these six other people that I come to learn are part of my soul group. I've lived past lives with them. They still are with me. They are an extension of my soul, I think. I'm not 100% sure, honestly. I'm not sure about any of this. This is all coming from imagination, but what I am sure about is how I feel about it. The feeling is exploring new territory that is mind, heart, and spirit opening. Me. So I'm dancing in this circle and I decide I wanna know who these people are. I wanna know where they come from and how I know them and It's the first time I've ever really felt like I connect with a group of people, a group, because I look at them in the eyes and I get information straight away about who they are and where they come from. And so I spend some time connecting with this soul group, and I don't really want to leave, because it feels like we were brothers and sisters in a past life. But I do, I leave the sun now and I come out and I'm greeted by Hathor, and I say to her, there's a door that I passed and I'd like to look in it. And she knows what door I'm talking about. And she cautions me against looking into this door, simply because there's a bit of pain there, and I already know the story, so to speak. But I feel like I don't fully know the story, and I need to revisit the story. And I feel as though it's important to say that the experiences I've had up until now, up until being the age of 24 that I am right now, there's been many pieces of the puzzle that I've been picking up along the way, and each year and each pivotal moment, like going through having an experience like this, more of the pieces of the puzzle fit together in a way that is so coherent and so beyond logic and faith even. It's so divine in its wholeness and magnificence that I feel sure of the message itself, which is to believe. Yeah, it's to believe. So I saw me and my sister, and we inhabited a whole planet to ourselves. And on this whole planet, we are given a half of the planet each to ourselves. And I see how we have these constant competitions between us both about whose side is better, whose powers of, or whose skills are higher, and typical sibling rivalry type stuff. And the most beautiful thing that I see is that we can, through our bodies, through our breath, and through our hands, we can build mountains. I can see me creating mountains, nature, like God creating earth almost. And I wonder, you know, how, if this is true, if this is really a past life of mine, I've been somebody that can create nature almost seemingly be in the role of God, but still not be in the role of God. There is still a higher oneness than that, even though it's quite epic. I get something out of understanding and asking, why me? Why would I get a life like this? This is so magnificent. This is unbelievable. This life that I had in a past life, it feels amazing. But what happens is that I hear a call whilst I'm on this planet. And the call is from Earth. She's calling out, and I hear her call, and after discussing it, pondering on it, I decide that I'm gonna go, and I'm gonna leave this beautiful planet here with my sister. And she tells me not to go, And I tell her I must, because I know it's part of my mission. And I see that the planet gets destroyed. My sister along with it, because she decided to stay, and I think she did it because she couldn't leave the beauty that we had created behind. She guarded it with everything she had. I see this planet get destroyed, and I understand now what Hathor was meaning. And for a moment I feel immense guilt and a deep understanding as to why I have carried around this regretful feeling for a while in my being, and so I decide to let it go. In the moment I let go of my guilt, because I know that the choices that we make, whatever they may be, we have to choose those choices. We have to remember the faith that we had in the moment when we made that choice. Because then, and only then, can we continue to have faith in the moment. And so, therein lies my mission, and that is to fulfill it here on Earth, to come and do what I came here to do. The part where I see this planet and me creating it with my sister, I'm uncomfortable with the notion that I could ever fulfill such a powerful role. Because, like you, I'm wondering, why me? Why would I be gifted this in a past life? With this question, I'm told to go to God, because Hathor doesn't quite know. Even though she's in between worlds, and I have a history with Hathor that maybe I could discuss in another video, but she's been a guiding goddess for me in my life, and even she doesn't know. So I'm told to go to spirit, and when I pluck up the courage, I rise up past this invisible path that I'm on. I see the light of heaven. And what I see are these fractals of colours, just on a spectrum of colour that is just vivid and beyond what I think my eyes have seen before. And I ask spirit humbly, why would I ever be granted the permission to live such a life as that? And the answer is shown to me, and it's the journey that I took to get to the sun. All of those doors that I passed, and the Great Spirit tells me, don't you know how ancient you are? And I take a moment to really think about having walked past all of those doors, all of them, past lives that I've lived. And with that comes the notion that this comforting feeling that I can tap into almost any skill, any talent or way of doing things that I could ever dream of. If only I remember how ancient I am. So I pay my respects to the Great Spirit, to Hathor, to everybody there. And I know it's my time to leave, because I've already gotten so much from this one journey, and I think in real time it's only been 30 minutes, but it seemed like I was under for a lot longer. And my beautiful winged lion friend flies me home, back to where I was lying on the yoga mat. One thing I'll say about my journey into these past lives, into this experience of mine, is that all I'm really doing is exploring my own imagination. And the belief that it's true is stronger because it feels true. It's not that I know it's true, it feels. Feels true, pure, resonant with my being. So, that exploration that I did, I wanted to share with you in case it helps to inspire you to go on a similar experience yourself. Because I'm very grateful to the synchronicity of the universe providing, as I say, the people, the right times, the right things to come into my world in order for me to have experienced that. And the many other countless blessings that I've experienced during my lifetime really helps me to remember those on the down days, in the down moments. Because there's so much magic to be gleaned. So, I wish you all a beautiful rest of your day or evening. I hope this has inspired you in some way, or given you some food for thought in some way. And let me know if you have any questions or ideas in the comments below. Peace, love, and light to you all.